it's Allison from Computers.mom, and today's video will show you how to set up a new backup drive for your Mac using Time Machine. We're going to walk through the steps quickly and cover some crucial pointers, but don't worry about taking notes because you'll find a detailed one-page recap of the steps at the end of this video. Every backup requires two things: a place to store the backup data and an app that manages what gets backed up and when. Macs come with Time Machine, which is an excellent backup app, but you'll need a storage device for the data. Most often, that's an external portable drive like this, or you can use a little flash drive. The key is that it has to have enough storage space for your backups and a connector that is compatible with your computer's ports. The rule of thumb is to buy a drive that has at least twice as much storage space as the computer you're backing up. You can easily find that information by clicking on the Apple menu, then About This Mac, then Storage. This particular computer has 256 gigabytes of storage space. For technical reasons, it says 251. You can ignore that small difference. So my backup drive needs to be at least 512 gigabytes. As for the connector, check the shape of the ports on your computer. You'll either need a rectangular USB-A connector like this for an older computer, or the flattened O shape of USB-C for a newer computer. As you can see, this cute little flash drive has both types, very handy. Let's plug it into the USB-C port on the side of this Mac. When you plug in a new device for the first time, it will normally appear on the desktop like this after a moment or two. This particular one is called No Name, which seems kind of dumb, so I'm going to rename it. This step is completely optional, but it can help you identify the device more easily. If you do rename it, keep the name short and avoid punctuation. Okay, C flash drive will work. Once the drive is connected and the computer recognizes it, all you have to do is set up Time Machine to use this drive for backup. I like to have the Time Machine icon on the menu bar up here for easy access. So I just click the little clock icon with the circular arrow and then choose Open Time Machine Preferences from the menu. If you don't have Time Machine on the menu bar already, you can get to the same exact place by opening System Preferences and selecting Time Machine here. You can see that I have a drive listed already. That was my old lessee backup drive. This little red icon is warning me that that drive isn't connected to the computer, so Time Machine cannot back up. I may use that drive again, but for now I want to set up the new flash drive as a backup drive, so I click Select Disk. In this window, you can see any drives you had already set up at the top, and then a list of drives that are available to be set up. Apple stopped making time capsules in 2018, so you probably won't need that option, but here's the new flash drive with its new name. If I select it and click Use Disk, the Mac will ask me if this disk is a replacement for the old one or an additional backup drive. I'm going to choose both. You will only see this question if you had already set up Time Machine with a different drive. The next question you may see is whether this new backup drive should be erased. Clicking erase always makes people nervous, but since it's brand new, we won't lose anything. All this does is make the drive compatible with Apple's storage system. If you're reusing a drive that has data on it, though, this will erase whatever was there. And you're done. Well, almost. The drive is now officially selected to be used for Time Machine backup on this computer. If you look closely, you'll see that Time Machine is waiting to perform the first backup. That backup will start automatically, as will every subsequent backup, as long as the drive is connected to the computer and the backup automatically checkbox right here is checked. Your first backup can take quite a while, but after that, Time Machine only backs up what is new or changed, so subsequent backups are faster. Remember, though, that if the drive isn't connected, no backups can happen. If we came back to this window later on, we would see the backup status listed under the drive, the date and time when it last backed up. Before we leave this window, two other small points. See the other checkbox right here? Checking this box is what puts the handy Time Machine icon on the menu bar for quick access, which I recommend. It's very convenient. Finally, note that the Select Disk button we used before is now called Add or Remove Backup Disk. But don't let that confuse you. It does exactly the same thing you saw before. If the Time Machine window is closed, You can check your backup progress by clicking on the Time Machine icon on the menu bar again. If it's finished, you'll see the date and time of your most recent backup. One last essential point. Never, ever, ever disconnect a backup drive without ejecting it first, because you can ruin the drive and lose all your backup data. There are a bunch of ways to eject a drive, but the easiest one, I think, is to open Finder, locate the drive in the navigation bar on the left side of the Finder window, and click the little eject button right next to it. When it disappears from the Finder window and from your desktop, it's safe to unplug it from the computer. As promised, here's a quick recap of the steps. Get a backup drive that has at least double the storage of your Mac. You can check that on your Mac by clicking the Apple menu, About This Mac, and then Storage. It should also have a connector that is compatible with the ports on your Mac. Plug it in and wait for it to appear on your desktop. Optionally, rename it if desired. Then click Open Time Machine from System Preferences. Click Select Disk or Add or Remove a Backup Disk, whichever one is showing. Select your new drive and click Use Disk. If asked, choose whether this is a replacement or an additional backup drive, and if asked, erase or format the new drive. All of the steps up to this point only need to be done once for each drive. Then you just leave the drive connected and backup will happen automatically on a schedule. If you need to disconnect the drive for any reason, like because you're moving your laptop, be sure to eject it first by clicking Finder, finding the drive on the left-hand side, and clicking the eject button next to it. That's all there is to it. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave comments and questions below. Click like if you found this helpful, and be sure to subscribe for more Computers.Mom videos.